How does a brand new mid-range phone compare to an older flagship phone? Well, in this video, we're gonna find out. What's up, guys? Kalipas Tech here, coming back at you with another video. In this video, we're gonna be doing a comparison between the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. We're gonna see what kind of advantages, if any, getting a brand new mid-range phone has over an older flagship phone. So let's get into it. So the Moto G Stylus 2021 has a 6.8-inch IPS LCD display with a resolution of 1080p, a PPI of 386, an aspect ratio of 20:9, and a screen-to-body ratio of 84.8%. Right now, I have the brightness at 100%, and it does look really good. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus has a 6.4-inch Super AMOLED display with a resolution of 1440p, a PPI of 550, an aspect ratio of 19:9, and a screen-to-body ratio of 88.3%. I have the brightness on this phone set to 100% as well, and I would say it looks just as good, if not better. So each of these phones does have its advantage. In this area, there's not really a clear winner, because although the display of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is quite a bit higher quality as far as resolution goes, and it has a Super AMOLED display versus an IPS LCD, meaning the colors are gonna be brighter and more powerful, the Moto G Stylus 2021 actually has a much larger display. So if you're doing something like streaming videos or playing a game or reading, where the quality of the image might not necessarily be irrelevant, but it might not be quite as important as being able to see everything a lot bigger, then the Moto G Stylus is definitely gonna have an advantage, because when the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus was released, it was a big phone for its time, but these days, phones are just so much bigger that the Moto G Stylus with its 6.8-inch display is gonna be a lot bigger than the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus with only a 6.4-inch display. On the other hand, if you're doing something like viewing photos where you really want that resolution to stand out, or if you just simply prefer to have a higher quality image over having a larger image, then the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is gonna have its advantage. In terms of how each phone looks, I do think it's about even. On one hand, the bezels are a lot thinner on the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, but the back looks really old and outdated. This definitely doesn't look like a new phone at all. This look really isn't a thing anymore. Whereas the back of the Moto G Stylus 2021 really does look like the back of a phone that was manufactured in 2021, it really does look good. It looks high quality. And even though this phone isn't a flagship phone, and this phone is, the Moto G Stylus 2021 does look like a pretty high-end phone itself, just because of the good build quality and the nice materials it's made of. For the front-facing camera, the Moto G Stylus 2021 has a hole-punch camera right here. It looks really clean, really nice, and it adds to the modern look of the phone. This camera is 16 megapixels. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus has a hole-punch front-facing camera as well. This is a special camera in the sense that you can actually take wide-angle photos with it, which I haven't seen on very many other phones. This camera is 10 megapixels. In terms of design and appearance, both front-facing cameras look pretty much the same. It's basically the exact same design. But in terms of functionality, the front-facing camera of the S10 Plus is gonna be a little bit better just because of the extra feature of being able to take wide-angle photos. Both of these phones have 128 gigabytes of internal storage with microSD card expansion, so it's really gonna be a lot. For the average user, you're probably not gonna run out of space or even come close for that matter. And if you're more of a power user, you're still most likely gonna be fine. You would need a lot of apps to fill up that much space. And if you have lots of photos and videos, you can always put that on a microSD card. The Moto G Stylus 2021 does not have wireless charging, but the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus does. So if that's a feature that's important to you, definitely keep that in mind. These phones have similar security features, both having a fingerprint scanner and face unlock. The Moto G Stylus 2021 has a fingerprint scanner right here on the power key, really nice spot for it and really good for functionality. Since you're gonna be touching the power key to unlock the phone anyway, it makes sense to be able to unlock it that way as well. Let's give it a try. There we go, one more time. And as you can see, it's super fast and responsive. Probably one of the fastest fingerprint scanners I've ever used. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, on the other hand, has a fingerprint scanner in the display. Now, I think that this fingerprint scanner looks a lot nicer, but it might not be quite as fast. Let's see. There we go, one more time. And there we go. So it is really close. I don't really think that the speed of a fingerprint scanner is a good deciding point on which phone you should get, but it is worth noting that the Moto G Stylus 2021 has a faster and more convenient fingerprint scanner, whereas the fingerprint scanner of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus might not be quite as fast or convenient, but it is still really good, and I think it looks a lot nicer and more modern than that of the Moto G Stylus. For the rear camera setup on the Moto G Stylus, we got a 48 megapixel rear camera, an 8 megapixel ultrawide camera, a 2 megapixel macro camera, and a 2 megapixel depth sensing camera. So pretty much every camera feature you could ask for. Definitely a good setup if you ask me. And for video, this phone's able to shoot in quality up to 4K in the rear camera and 1080p in the front. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus has a 12 megapixel rear camera, a 12 megapixel telephoto lens, and a 16 megapixel ultrawide camera. For video, this phone's able to shoot in qualities up to 4K in both the rear and the front cameras. So feature-wise, these are really close. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus does not have a macro camera, but the telephoto lens is a substitute for that. It's able to do pretty much the exact same thing. Now, the quality of the photos taken by these cameras is gonna be pretty close. The Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 has a really high megapixel camera, but the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, being a flagship phone, is gonna have a much better sensor than any mid-level phone, is gonna have a much better sensor than a mid-level phone, especially considering, even though this is an older flagship phone, it's not super old. It was released in 2019, so it's still recent enough to have a lot of really nice features that can easily compete with a mid-level phone made today. Another advantage the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus has over the Moto G Stylus 2021 is that it can shoot 4K in the front-facing camera as well as the rear camera, so that is something to keep in mind. Internally, the Moto G Stylus 2021 is getting 4 GB of RAM with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 678 processor. Arena Geekbench 5 benchmark tests on this phone, and it came back with a single core score of 538 and a multi-core score of 1588, so not bad at all. This phone's gonna be able to do almost anything you need it to, except I wouldn't run a super high-end game like Fortnite on this phone because it will probably have a little bit of trouble. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is getting 8 GB of RAM with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 processor. I ran a Geekbench 5 benchmark test on this phone as well, and it came back with a single core score of 730 and a multi-core score of 2643. So this one is quite a bit more powerful than the Moto G Stylus 2021, and not by a small amount either. So if processing power is one of the more important things for you, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is definitely gonna have a huge advantage here as a general rule of thumb, while the Moto G Stylus 2021 can do almost anything you need it to, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is gonna be able to do actually anything you would need it to. As far as the battery goes, the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 is gonna have a bit of an advantage here, with a 4,000 milliamp hour battery versus a 3,400 milliamp hour battery. Now, this isn't a huge difference. It's not like the iPhone 12 with a 2,815 milliamp hour battery that's just so small that pretty much any battery in the world will beat it, but it is a sizable difference. The battery of the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 is about 17% larger than the battery of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Now again, it's not a huge difference, But if battery life is one of the more important factors for you, the Moto G Stylus 2021 is probably going to be a better option. Another thing I want to point out is the software. Now, this is a bit of an interesting one because the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, being an older phone, usually has the disadvantage of being an older phone because updates don't last forever. And since it's been out for a while, updates on older phones usually are already over or coming to an end. But as of right now, updates for the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus are still being supported. As you can see by the little Edge console, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is in fact running on Android 11, whereas the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 is still on Android 10, and I'm not sure when this is gonna change, if at all. So if you get the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021, there's really no guarantee that you're even gonna get Android 11. Now, if getting the latest version of Android is important to you, then I don't think either of these phones are gonna be your best bet, just because the Moto G Stylus 2021 currently isn't supporting updates, and I don't think it ever will. In the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, even though it's supporting updates right now, being able to run an Android 11, there's no guarantee that that's gonna continue for much longer. But that being said, based on the current software, if you do want the newest thing out of the two, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is actually gonna have the advantage. So in conclusion, which of these devices is the better choice? I would say it really depends on your needs. As far as the display goes, that's where there's a huge difference. On one hand, the Motorola Moto G Stylus 2021 has a much larger display, but the Samsung Galaxy S10 has a better quality display. With 1440p versus 1080p, you will see a difference for sure. And the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus has a Super AMOLED display versus an IPS LCD display. So that is a huge difference. If you value the size of the display, the Moto G Stylus 2021 is gonna be the better option, but if you prefer better quality, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is gonna be better. As far as processing power goes, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus definitely has a huge advantage here. So if that is one of the more important factors for you, then without question, the S10 Plus is the way to go. If you are looking for the features and quality and processing power of a flagship phone, I would say the S10 Plus is gonna be your best option. But if you want slightly longer battery life and a larger display and the benefit of having a brand new phone, the Moto G Stylus 2021 is gonna be the better option. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.